The Natural Sciences and Engineering Research Council supports students at all stages of their post-secondary education. This video will provide information about NSERC's programs for postgraduate students. The information is up to date as of the 2011 application year. Keep in mind that this is intended as an overview only. For more details, you should read the complete program description and instructions for completing an application. This tutorial will guide you through the process of applying for a postgraduate scholarship or Canada Graduate Scholarship from NSERC. This process requires you to complete Form 201 on NSERC's online system and submit it electronically. To apply for a postgraduate scholarship online, go to the home page on the NSERC website. Select Online Services from the left-hand menu, or select Login from the bottom left of any page on the site. We strongly recommend that you review the instructions for Form 201, Application for an NSERC Postgraduate Scholarship or Postdoctoral Fellowship. You can find the instructions by selecting the PDF Forms and Instructions link. Remember that this tutorial is intended as an overview and will not cover every aspect of completing this form. If you have questions that are not answered by the information on our website, contact NSERC's Online Services Help Desk. If you are a previous user, log into the site. Otherwise, register as a first-time user. On the eConsole page, choose Forms, Student. On the My Portfolio page, select Form 201 from the drop-down menu. Then select Create. The next page will prompt you to choose which program you are applying to and input the title of your proposal. After you create a file, you can close and reopen it as often as you wish. The system will prompt you to save your information every time you move to another page. Note that the system will log you out automatically without saving your changes after a period of inactivity. The left side of the screen indicates a list of pages to be completed for the specific programs for which you're applying. As you select each page, enter the appropriate information on the screen. Refer to the instructions as you need to. On the application profile page, select the option that describes your registration status. If you select A or B, you will submit your application directly to NSERC. If you select C or D, you will submit your application through your university, and you will have to identify your university and department. The PIN referred to in this page is assigned to you by NSERC. If you have submitted an application in the past and don't remember your PIN, contact the Online Services Help Desk. Return to the eConsole page and enter your PIN. It will then appear automatically on the Person Profile page. If this is your first application to NSERC, leave this field blank. Your PIN is not your social insurance number, student number, or the reference number provided by the online system. Some of the information requested here, such as your status as a visible minority or disabled person, is used for statistical and administrative purposes only. Please enter your current mailing address and contact information. It is very important to notify NSERC of any changes by email or telephone. Any updates you make through the online system after an application has been submitted will not be associated with that application. You may choose whether to include degrees outside the natural sciences and engineering. If you have fast-tracked to a doctoral program, specify the date when you officially transferred to the doctoral program. You will be required to provide all transcripts for any program of study listed in this section. Use this page to enter any of your work experience that is relevant to this application. You can list up to 6 entries that describe experience in science or engineering, or that demonstrate your research ability, leadership, and communication skills. Experiences gained as part of a program of study are appropriate to include. On this page, List up to 10 awards that you have received as part of a competitive process, including previous awards from NSERC. You may also include non-monetary awards. Include all the awards that have been offered to you, even if you declined them. The value of each award should also be indicated. You can list up to 3 Canadian or foreign locations where you would like to hold your scholarship. You may hold your scholarship abroad only if you have received at least 1 degree from a Canadian university in the natural sciences and engineering. The CGS can only be held at a Canadian university. The program of study that you indicate here must be eligible within NSERC's mandate. In the proposed degree program field, be sure to indicate the degree program for which you are applying. If you are proposing a foreign location for your award and have agreed to be considered for a Canada Graduate Scholarship or the NSERC Andre Hamer Prize, you will have an opportunity to reconsider your choice of location if your application is successful. This page should be completed only by applicants for doctoral level awards. Provide a summary of your most recently completed thesis or thesis in progress. For some, this may be an honors thesis completed for a bachelor's program. If you have not completed or worked on a thesis, summarize your research experiences to date, major projects, papers, or work experience. This information should be different from what you will enter on the proposed research page. Select a research subject code that best describes your discipline. This code will also determine the selection committee that is most suited to evaluate your application. You may choose up to 10 keywords that describe your area of research more closely. These will help NSERC staff assign your application to the most appropriate reviewers on the selection committee. This one-page outline of your proposed research program is a very important part of the application and is also used to verify subject eligibility. Before you complete this section, read the instructions carefully. Even if you have not yet defined your research direction, you must complete this section since the selection committee will be evaluating your ability to write a research proposal and your knowledge of the field. You are not bound to the proposed research project as long as your new project still falls within NSERC's mandate. Describe your research in as much detail as possible. The information should include your overall objectives, an outline of your approach, the methods and procedures you plan to use, and the significance of your research to the field you are studying and to the natural sciences and engineering. The focus of your proposed research should be what you plan to undertake for the period during which you are to hold the award. If your research is a continuation of your current thesis, clearly state the differences between the work that you have done for your thesis and the research activities outlined in this proposal. The content must be written by you. It should not be an extract from your supervisor's grant proposal, nor should it refer reviewers to internet links or other publications for details. You should include appropriate references, but these have to remain within the page limitation. The system will only allow you to attach a one-page document. Complete this section if your research is in a discipline that falls under the mandate of more than one federal granting agency, such as psychology, management studies, geography, physical education, biomedical engineering, health sciences, bioinformatics, or biostatistics. Describe the natural sciences or engineering research challenges of the project on which you propose to work during the tenure of your scholarship or fellowship. Explain clearly what you will be doing and why it should be considered research that is predominantly natural sciences or engineering. This section should not exceed 1 page. There are 3 parts to the document you must attach on the Contributions Statements page. It is important to follow the order and format as outlined in the instructions and adhere to the page limit identified for your program. For PGS-D applicants, it is critical that you describe your role in each of the various contributions. Describe as clearly as you can the impact of your contributions. Do not underestimate the influence this section can have on the evaluation of your application. If any of these sections do not apply to your situation, indicate this in your application. The committee should not be left with unanswered questions. NSERC will not accept updates to this information once it has been submitted. In this section, describe any special considerations that have had an effect on your performance or productivity. Refer to the instructions for further details on how to complete this section. PGS-M applicants must supply this information on the Special Circumstances page of their application. PGS-D applicants should include this information in Part 3 of the Contributions Statements page of their application. If you are a PGS applicant applying directly, you must scan and upload your transcripts. All undergraduate and graduate transcripts must be scanned into one combined file, including a copy of the university legend for each set of transcripts. It should be formatted as a black and white printed document, and where possible, in portrait style. Only the portions of your transcript that reflect your academic record need to be included. If you are successful in the competition, you may be asked to submit the official copies for verification before you take up your award. If your transcripts are in a language other than English or French, they must be translated and certified. If you are a PGS applicant applying through the university, official and up-to-date undergraduate and graduate transcripts must be scanned and uploaded by the individual designated by the Office of Graduate Studies at your institution. On this page, you'll be asked to enter the name and email address of your university designate. Once you save the information, an email will be generated by the online system inviting the designate to upload your transcript. You will also be able to see the status of your request. It is your responsibility to ensure that the university designate has an official and up-to-date transcript for each program listed on the academic background page. If your transcripts are in a language other than English or French, they must be translated and certified. Your application must include two reports on the applicant. These reports should be prepared by people who are familiar with your work, which normally includes your thesis supervisor and another academic or workplace supervisor. You should provide your referees with a realistic deadline, as well as helpful information, such as details about yourself, that may remind them of your research, leadership abilities, and communication skills. These reports can have a significant effect on the success of your application. Reviewers use them as a source of supplementary information and as an independent verification of other information you provide. If your thesis supervisor is not providing one of the reports, you should indicate the reason. Applicants for PGS-M awards provide these on the Special Circumstances page. Applicants for PGS-D awards include this information in the Contributions and Statements page. You should communicate with your referees well before the deadline and give them the option to say no. On this page, enter the names and email addresses of your referees. Once you save this information, an email will be generated by the online system inviting the referees to complete their report on the applicant. You will also be able to see the status of your request. You have now completed entering your information. Select the Portfolio menu item to continue. This page allows you to verify that your application is complete. Correct the errors listed on the verification report and re-verify. When your verification report shows that your application is complete, submit it electronically. It is important to note that NSERC will not accept changes to the application once it has been submitted. We would like to leave you with these last reminders. Remember, follow instructions. Pay attention to font size, margins, page limits, etc. Make sure you use clear, concise writing. Proofread for spelling and grammar. Be sure to provide all needed documentation. Choose your referees with care. and be aware of the deadline. NSERC's online resources also include two other videos, one that offers tips on making your application stand out for reviewers, and another that explains the peer review process that happens after you submit your application. If you have questions, please refer back to the instructions for completing Form 201 or other documents on our website, or contact us directly.